خوف أمام الله وانصتوا لسماع الإنجيل المقدس فصل من بشارة الإنجيل بحسب ما كتبه معلمنا ماري لوقا البشير التلميذ الطاهر بركاته.
Amen.
من مزامير وتراتيل معلمنا داود النبي بركاته علينا آمين. الرب عز لشعبه وهو مؤازر الخلاص مسيحه. خلص شعبك بارك ميراثك ارعاهم وارفعهم إلى الآباد. مبارك هو الآتي باسم الرب ربنا وإلهنا ومخلصنا وملكنا كلنا يسوع المسيح ابن الله الحي الذي له المجد الدائم
إلى
له واحدا من الفريسيين أن يأكل معه، فلما دخل بيت الفريسي اتكأ، وإذا امرأة في المدينة كانت خاطئة، إذا علمت أنه متكئ في بيت الفريسي، أخذت قارورة طيب ووقفت عند قدميه من وراءه باكية، وابتدأت تبل قدميه بدموعها وتمسحهما بشعر رأسها، وكانت تقبل قدميه ودسهما بالطيب. فلما رأى الفريسي الذي دعاه ذلك تكلم في نفسه قائلا: لو كان هذا نبيا لعلم من هي المرأة التي لمسته وما حالها، إنها لخاطئة. فأجاب يسوع وقال له: يا سمعان، عندي كلمة أقولها لك. أما هو فقال: قل أيها المعلم. فأجاب يسوع وقال له: كان لمدين مديونان، كان على الواحد 500 دينار وعلى الآخر 50، وإذ لم يكن لهما ما يوفيان سامحهما كليهما، فمن منهما يحبه أكثر؟ فأجاب سمعان وقال: أظن أن الذي سامحه بالأكثر. أما هو فقال له: بالثواب حكمت. ثم التفت إلى المرأة وقال لسمعان: أترى هذه المرأة؟ إني دخلت بيتك وماء لأجل رجلي لم تعطي، أما هذه فقد بلت رجلي بدموعها ومسحتهما بشعرها. أنت لم تقبل فمي، وأما هذه فمنذ دخلت بيتك لم تكف عن تقبيل رجلي، بزيت لم تدهن رأسي، وأما هذه فقد دهنت بالطيب رجلي. من أجل ذلك أقول لك إن خطاياها الكثيرة مغفورة لها لأنها أحبت كثيرا، والذي يغفر له قليل يحب قليل. ثم قال لها: مغفورة لك خطاياك. فابتدأ المتكئون يقول في أنفسهم: من هو هذا الذي يغفر خطايا أيضا؟ فقال للمرأة: إيمانك قد خلصك، اذهبي بسلام.
المجد لله Save your people and bless your inheritance, shepherd them also and bear them up forever. Blessed is he who comes in the name of our Lord, O Lord God and Savior and King of us, the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Glory be to you forever. Amen. Then one of the Pharisees asked him to eat with him, and he went up, and he went to the Pharisee's house and sat down to eat. And behold, a woman in the city who was a sinner, when she knew that Jesus was at the table in the Pharisee's house, brought an alabaster flask of fragrant oil and stood at his feet behind him weeping, and she began to wash his feet with her hair and wipe them with the hair of her head. And she kissed his feet and anointed them with fragrant oil. Now when the Pharisee who had invited him saw this, he spoke to himself, saying, this man, if he were a prophet, would know who and what manner this woman is that is who is touching him, for she is a sinner. And Jesus answered and said to him, Simon, I have something to say to you. And he said, Teacher, say it. There was a certain creditor who had two debtors. One owed 500 denarii and the other 50. And when he had nothing with which to repay, he freely forgave them both. Tell me, therefore, which of them will love him more? Simon answered and said, I suppose the one who forgave more. And he said to him, You have rightly judged. And then he turned to the woman and said to Simon, Do you see this woman? I entered your house, and you gave me no water for my feet, but she has washed my feet with her tears and wiped them with the hair of her head. And you gave me no kiss, but this woman did not cease to kiss my feet since the time I came in. You did not anoint my head with oil, but this woman has anointed my feet with fragrant oil. Therefore I say to you, her sins, which are many, are forgiven, for she loved much. But to whom little is forgiven, the same loves little. And he said to her, Your sins are forgiven. And those who sat at the table with him began to say to themselves, Who is this who even forgives sins? And he said to the woman, Your faith has saved you. Go in peace.
Glory be to God forever.
The fourth week of the month of Sukkot, may his blessing be with all. Amen. As we hear the story of the Sinner woman, and this is the only time mentioned in all the four Gospels, was mentioned in book of St. Luke, chapter 7, the one we hear today. Beautiful story about repentance. One lady, she come to Jesus, she was a sinner, and everyone he know she is a sinner, and she come, she didn't say one word. But the tears she was giving in this story, she was saying everything. Because she didn't say much at all, she attracted a lot of the scholar, a lot of people writing about her story. His Holiness Pope, you know, they write about her in Book of the Repentance. Saint Ephrem the Syrian write a story, beautiful one, they call The Tears and Love. And they explain the story exactly like how she gave up the sin and she went and they sell everything and she buys this perfume or alabaster and she wear it in Jesus' feet. How we know the person he repented or not? For the whatever they tell him, he accepted. This woman, she knows she's a sinner. She knows she coming to this house and she knows she can get some not nice word at all. Not believed words can come to her, but she accepts all this one for the sake of repentance and the sake of forgiveness of her sin. What we want to talk about today, the verse God tell her, Your sin be forgiven. Your sin be forgiven. To accept this one and we hear this one, we have to repent. And to repent, you have to, we not call it, excuse me, only, not only we call repent, we say the sacrament of repentance and confession. The gospel, he tell us today, إن قلنا إنه ليس لنا خطية نضل أنفسنا وليس الحق فينا. If I think I am without sin, I deceive myself. That's all. Unfortunately, we hear a lot of people now, they tell you, I confess to God. And this is some plague or disease can come to the Christian now. We want to see the scholar of the church and what the gospel say about this. That's very important. Number one, the sacrament of repentance and confession. Without repentance and confession, there is no heaven. That's number one, so put in your mind. Why? Because there is some sacrament. Without them, we can't go to heaven. Like what? Repentance, confession, Holy Communion, baptism, Holy Marian. Without this, you can't go to heaven. But some of the sacrament, without this, we can go to heaven. Like priesthood, like the marriage, like the anointing of the sick. Without this, you can't go to heaven. So the number one, we have to understand, without confession and repentance, there is no heaven. That's number one, so black and white. I was looking for all the father, early father of the church, first century, second century, third century, fourth century, until the year 1600 or something, until the Protestant started to tell people there is no confession, all the church was practice confession. So if someone he come now and tell me there is no confession to person, to priest, that's completely he has no idea about Christianity and the history of the church. And to confess and God accept your repentance in its four stage. So last stage of them, you come and sit with Abuna, but you have to repair yourself before this. Number one, to confess, you have to confess between you and yourself, and you feel you are a sinner, and you and you want to change your life. Sam Macarius, he said, son, judge yourself before they judge you. Suddenly, a lot of people, you tell him what you've done, he is wrong. You need to abolish. He said, no, I abolish you only, but I believe what I did is correct. One of the priests, he got someone, he killed a person. So in his jail, he wants to repent. So Abuna, he come to give him, to take his confession. And Abuna, he won't test him because he can't give him absolution unless he makes sure he repented. He told him, if the person you killed him wake up again and alive, what you gonna do to him? He said, I will kill him again. He said, you didn't repent. You still the hate and the evil in your heart. I can't give you absolution. I cannot give you Holy Communion. So number one, you have to sit with yourself and believe you are a sinner and you want to change your life. The word repentance, I want to change my life. That's matanya. You want to change your direction. So number one. Number two, you want to make sure you confess and make sure you confess to the person you sin against him. What this means? You want to make sure if I upset someone, or I take something not mine from someone, like what happened with the chaos. He said, if I took anything not supposed to be mine, I will half of my money, I will give it back, and everyone I take him something falsely, I will bring it for time. If you say something about someone bad, you need to go and tell him. If you took something not yours, you have to go and bring it back to the person. You have to. Bab Shinoda, I remember I said this story before. Bab Shinoda, he said, when he explained about the confession, he said one of the priests was when he went to one of the church in Egypt, and olden days he wearing like he has golden watch in his pocket, and someone Christian, he saw him, he want to walk behind him until he went to church, and he said, Abuna, I want to confess. He said, son, I just only here visitors my church in Upper Egypt, I come for wedding here. He said, but I want to confess to you, Abuna, because it's a blessing in your face. So he confessed during the confession, he stole Abuna watch. And during the confession, he said, Abuna, I stole a watch. Can you give me absolution? Abuna gave him absolution. So His Holiness Pope Shenouda, he said, if the priest told him, go and give this person his watch back, at least Abuna, he can get his watch. So when you confess, it's very important. If you take something not yours, you have to bring it back. You have to give it to the person. If you say something wrong about someone, you have to go and make sure this person. Because the church tells us, before you put your bread on the altar, go reconcile with your friends. Leave your bread, leave the mass and go. Abuna Mikhail Ibrahim, one of the servants, come to him during he puts infants around the church and tell him, Abuna, last week in Sunday school class, one of the parents understand me wrong, and he come, he tell me, not please what. So Abuna, he told him, and you want to have a Holy Communion today? He said, yes, Abuna. He said, and you upset the man? He said, I didn't upset him. He's the one upset me. He said, go and make sure he upset. Leave the church now and go to him. He went and tell the man, you upset for me? He said, no, I am the one who's wrong. And he come, he tell Abuna, said, in this case, I can give you Holy Communion. You have to make sure no one upset from you before you have Holy Communion. That's why Saint Paul, he said in 1 Corinthians, I will say it in Arabic, is أي من أكل هذا الخبز أو شرب كأس الرب بدون استحقاق يأكل ويشرب دينونة لنفسه غير مميز جسد الرب من أجل هذا فيكم كثيرون ضعفاء كثيرون مرضى وكثيرون يركضون عشان بياخدوا كاسة الرب ودمه بدون استحقاق. كورنثوس الأولى 11 17 ل 19. So number one, I have to make sure I am a sinner and I sit with myself. Number two, I confess the person if I sin against him. Number three, you need to confess to God. You sit with God. You want to talk to him. You want to tell him, God, help me, I don't want to do this again. Number four, you come and sit with the priest. Not all the sin will say the priest, something good in your life too, you say, because the confession not put you down all the time. If you pray more, if you want to read more in the Bible, if you want to give some more money, if you want to do anything, tell Abuna, Abuna be happy and encourage you. And when you sit with Abuna, Abuna give you three things. Number one, he give you absolution from your sin. He take your sin and put in head of Jesus Christ. Number two, if you have a problem, you help you. Like exactly the doctor. We go to the doctor to give us some medicine for our body. Abuna, he give you some medicine for your spirit. Number three, Abuna allowed you to have Holy Communion, because some of the sin, Abuna, he not can allow you to have Holy Communion. After this one, after Abuna give you الحل والحل ويسمح لك بالتناول. Abuna hekhalik tismah lak tisam. One of the people come to his home is Bab Shinoda. And Bab Shinoda, when he was talking about confession, one he told him, His Holiness, I confess to God Shadoi. How he answered him, he said, Let God give you the Holy Communion. Shadoi. Another one he said, I don't want to confess. His Holiness Bab Shinoda, he said, If someone is scared for confession, he do two sins. He killed or make adultery. He said, I never kill anyone. His Holiness said, that means you confess now. Okay? People is scared from the confession. The devil wants you to get delay from the confession. Why? Because the devil wants us tomorrow and tomorrow and tomorrow and until you forgot. I'm in the school holiday. After the school holiday, I will confess. After the school holiday, you visit the study. After the study, after the test, I will confess. After the test, they come. Big school holiday, you go overseas or you go holiday. You find the people day after day. So they not gonna confess. If we look to the confession in Old Testament from Book of Leviticus, they used to the people coming to the priest and everyone confessed in his sin and put his hand on the sacrifice and he confessed his sin. So they slew the animal. So they tell him, this innocent animal die for your sin. Like exactly when God died on the cross for our sin. If we look to John the Baptist, he was the last priest in Old Testament. He said, I baptize you, and he was confessing with your sin. If you remember, Joshua, son of Nun, was Achan ibn Karma, he told him, confess to God, and they come and tell me. The apostles, in Book of Acts 19, everyone was coming and confessing with their sin. And when we confess, we have to confess with everything. Don't hide anything. One person, after the confession, he was hiding something and he feel disappointed. He feel upset. Until next week, he saw the priest again and tell him, Abuna, I'm still upset. I'm not happy. Abuna said, I will pick it up. And they tell him, did you confess with everything? He said, Abuna, there's something I want to do. He said, come. After he confessed with everything, he feel released. He feel happy. He feel already clean himself. Like exactly someone he got bugs in his stomach. Unless he gets everything out of your stomach, these bugs will work again and again and again. From where Abuna he got this authority? That's from Jesus Christ himself. When he breathed for people, for apostle or disciple, faith and said, receive the Holy Spirit. And whatever sin you forgive will be forgiven, and your name will be forgiven. People, the Protestant, they take the verse of book of Epistle of St. James and says, confess to each other. But if you read 3-4 verses before, he said, if someone sick, get him the priest of the church and anoint with oil, and the prayer of the righteous people can heal him, and they start to talk about the confession. I cannot go to the street and confess to someone, but they not understand. People, they think they can get away with confession. The church was very clear. Unless you confess and you repent, there is no heaven. A lot of mistakes some people, they do in the confession. He come to the confession and they confess about someone else. You coming and you confess only about yourself. One of the monks, he came to his Holiness Bab Shinoda, and Bab Shinoda wrote it in his book. He said, can I confess? He said, come. He said, Father, this he done 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and he was talking all the time about this another monk. So his Holiness was nice word. He said, better bring him here, I can give him the absolution. Because you didn't confess about yourself, you confess about him. Sometime we'll be friendly with the confession father. No, you have to make sure that exactly the judge. Why exactly judging? Because God, He will ask Abuna about the spiritual level of his people. We'll bring it from where? In Book of Ezekiel, chapter 3, and Book of Ezekiel, chapter 33. What they said? He said, if you see the sinner and you not warn him and he die in his sin, I will ask you his blood from your hand. And if you warn him and he didn't repent, you innocent from his blood. I will say it in Arabic, and I already translated in English. إن قلت للشرير موتا تموت وما أنذرته أنت ولا تكلمت إنذارا للشرير عن طريقه الردية ولا حياته فذلك الشرير يموت باسمه أما دمه فمن يدك أطلبه. وإن أنذرت أنت الشرير ولم يرجع عن شره ولا عن طريقه الرديئة فإنه يموت باسمه أما أنت فقد نجيتنا. Very important. Abuna, he needs to know the level of the people. Abuna, before he gives anyone his holy communion, he makes sure these people repented, because Abuna will ask him for this authority. So this is the blessing he took it from God. He has to be honest on this blessing to give it to everyone. That's why Abuna, he needs to know the spirituality of the level of the church. That's why Abuna, he needs to hear. Can you go to the judge and tell him, judge, you are very smart. This is my case. Can you judge me? I said, unless I hear, I cannot judge you. That's exactly, until we tell Abuna, he can to guide us. So it's very important. This is the story about the sinner woman today. In the end of the story, she hears the word she was coming for. Your sins are forgiven. If we want our sin to be forgiven, we need to follow this four steps. Number one, we feel we are a sinner. We want to change our life. Number two, we confess to God and ask His guidance, ask His blessing to help us. Number three, we confess to the person we sin against him. Number four, we come and confess to Abuna. That's what the church teaching us. If someone coming now and said me, I confess only to God, like His Holiness Pope Shenouda, he tell him, let God give you Holy Communion. Glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.